Thank you. Thank you, everyone. You're too kind.
Thought I had you there.
Enjoying staring at that ball I got you, boy. No fun if it doesn't fight back, huh?
The hell-forged, multi-headed monster feels no urgency to waste his precious time on simple playthings, much preferring to conserve his vast energy reserves, in case any trespassers need to be eaten suddenly.
Well, it's there if you change your mind. I mean, old father's nice to you at least, isn't he, boy? Here's the commission. Let's get some undead flower petals over there post haste. Contractor, I have another job. More music to soothe the senses.
I had envisioned that you would succeed.
Chamber music. Don't you ever get lonely down here, Nix? For companionship, I mean. Because, well, I mean, just look at you. You're very beautiful, the knight herself. There's nothing you can't do. When I was younger, I thought you and father, you know. But is there not someone else?
How very forward of you, child. I accept your compliment. Although I am the knight, as you observe. The knight conceals all. I know nothing of the loneliness which you describe. This entire realm, it is a part of me, and many of its subjects sprang from me alone.
I see. Forgive my rudeness.
I knew you could do it. The pomegranate trees are coming in nicely still, the tough old things.
Love you, Mother. I had another question about your relationship to other Gorgons, Dusa. So, I notice you're not much for hissing, snake-like noises when you speak, and so on. Is that some sort of special Gorgon language or something?
No, not exactly, Prince. It's what it sounds like. Hiss! Just scary hissing, really. It takes some practice not to sound like that with a forked tongue. I really wanted to fit in. Hey, how about you? I always wondered how come you have a surface accent. Weren't you born here?
Oh, wait, me? I never gave it any thought. I guess it's from my father. He insisted that he teach me how to speak himself. Maybe it's in the blood.
Maybe it is!
Those spices working out all right. Totally worth it. Take that deal.
Your Highness.
Let's get to work. Lord Ares.
Ah, you bear the bloodfruit vial which I granted you. The mortal's blood contained therein. I drew it myself. Too seldom am I able to become directly involved in such matters.
Violence. Knuckleheads. You're mine. Got me a knucklehead. Sir?
You know, Prince said, you really have a look about you that you know exactly where you're going as of late. I used to think you weren't near as comfortable in your own skin.
Well, you were right. I was never comfortable performing Father's routine Tartarus inspections. Though those responsibilities of mine didn't last long.
Nor did we have much opportunity to chat back then. But hey, you always struck me as a decent sort. Wasn't accustomed to your father's henchpeople greeting me with a smile. Sure thing.
Thank you, mate.
Stop by again sometime.
You and me.
He's good at making mortals kill each other, yes, but he has utterly no knack for subtlety.
I have a better idea.
Gratitude.
The whims of our kind are unpredictable, my kin, but you shall find responses to such acts to be the definition of consistency.
So that's the way it is, then. I guess he's upset.
Survive. Bravo. Our score is settled up for now, so let us carry on as friends.
I implore the fates.
Achilles, he continues to ignore my polite outreach, doesn't he? Why, I've attempted to reach out at least several times. Your father's realm is really quite a lot. How terribly frustrating it must be.
Kieran's shop. Pleasure doing business. Gods grant me strength.
Stands for all time's sake.
Strictly business. Let's hear it, Father. Any boons worth giving up? Let's see here. Might help. Should be useful.
Broke out of Tartarus.
Got it. next island. Ready when you are, Barge of Death. Just right.
Suggest to be very quick about it, and might give you this.
I'll take this one. Feel, Ernie. sure.
That's it for Asphodel. Courtesy of the Pact.
Style. Sharpened.
Such as this, you know. Nevertheless, there is a price which must be paid for it.
Well, that's that.
Do that.
last so long, my kin. This one is not worth the pursuit, I think, when we can wage a greater one together.
Fishes. Cheers, mate.
I wished only to speak to you in private once again, my kin, except, you see...
Except you see, dear cousin, that some members of our family are predisposed toward the unspeakable. I caution you around my half-brother is all. Now carry on.
You interrupt me once again, dear sister. You know I do not care for that. I warn you to stay out of my affairs. I shall aid my kin as I see fit.
You only do as you see fit, Lord Ares. Mind that you continue pulling in the same direction as us all.
In exchange. Kill or be killed. Here's the fee. You're late. I'll just take that. Here then. Should come in useful. Power of the Goddess.
Waste not more words with this one, King. Let's fight.
Not for you, monster. say to never meet your heroes. First.
Hey, a satyr sack already. Cerberus can never get enough of this stuff.
I'm pleased to see your father's stubbornness is manifest in you as such determination, Zagreus. My blessing be with you.
Yum. Now for a chat with Cerberus. Why not? Good enough to eat.
Cerberus again accepts the sack.
Fight for now, boy. I don't think I'll ever get accustomed to the breeze.
So, Varatha and Gygaros are to clash again upon this empty field. Let us have at it then. Thank you. With your youth comes a certain strength, it seems. Again, you.
By my father's name. Blood of the Titans.
Just then, the carefree running underworld prince runs headlong into a thick and deadly wall of stone, painted to look like the way out.